Hey guys, today's video is about k-fold cross-validation for hyperparameter tuning. We'll use decision tree as an example, and we'll use Titanic dataset. Actually, we talked about this example in the previous video, so we'll quickly go through the first few steps. If you don't understand any of these concepts, please check out my previous video of decision tree. First, we need to import the packages we need to use, and then we can read the data. I'll just use URL to read a CSV file, and you can find the URL in the code I provide in the description below. So now we have our data. Then we have to pre-process the data. We'll remove irrelevant column and missing values. So again, if you don't know what I'm doing, please check out my previous video. We will first drop the typing column, and then we drop all the missing values. Then we have to transform the column sex to numbers. It's originally strings, female and male, and we'll use label encoder. So you just create an instance and convert the column. Fit transform, you put the column. Okay, now we complete our pre-processing. Let's look at our data. So here are the first five rows of our data, and indeed we convert the sex and we remove the typing. So now we can decide what variables we want to use. I'll just pick all the numerical columns, but you can pick your own variables as you wish. So X equals data, and P class, sex, age, speed, SP, patch, and fare. And the target variable is whether a passenger will survive. So it's just this column here. So 0 means a passenger didn't survive, and 1 means the passenger survived. Okay. P class. So, okay. And then we can split our data into training and testing sets. Typically, training set is only used for training, but in this example, we'll use training sets to do cross validation. Before doing cross-validation, let's split our data. We'll split our data into 80-20, means 80% of data is training and testing data has 20% of total data. So X train, X test, Y train, Y test equals to this function here can help us directly split the data, test size, random stats. So you can assign any random stats as you wish. It just, when we assign a random stats, Python will always return the same split for us. Okay, now we can move on to hyperparameter tuning. In specific, we'll use grid search and cross-validation to find out the best combination of parameters. So let's first check out what parameters we can tune. So here are the hyperparameters we can specify before training a model. So for simplicity, we are only tune criteria and maximum depth. Of course, you can tune more hyperparameters and you can see which combinations are better, but we just choose these two hyperparameters because they are commonly used and we don't want our computation time to be too long. Okay, so we create criteria on these. They are our candidates and our maximum depth list. Then we need to iterate over every possible combination. So for CRI, criteria list, okay. For depth, in maximum depth list, we create a decision tree classifier. RT run equals to CRI, maximum depth equals to depth. All right, we have our decision tree classifier. Then we can do cross validation. What k-fold cross validation does is essentially partitioning the data into k-folds, and you'll use one fold as validation set and the remaining folds as training set. Training set is used to train the model. Validation set is used to evaluate the model's performance. So this process will be repeated k times, since each fold has to be used as validation set once. If you are a little bit confused, don't worry. We have this function called cross-validate. It performs k-fold cross-validation for us. All we need to do is paste in the model, independent and target variables of training data, the k we want to assign, and the scoring metric. Scoring metric is the metric we use to evaluate the model, and we evaluate the model on validation set. In this example, we'll just use accuracy for simplicity, but as you might know, accuracy is not comprehensive. And we just use this for demo. You can select the scoring metric you want. All right, now we can perform k-fold cross validation, and we'll specify k as 5, scores equals to cross validate. The model dt is the model here, and x train, y train, the variables of training data, and then we specify k. K is essentially the number of cross validation folds, so CV equals to 5, and scoring metrics is accuracy. However, each fold will have one validation score, and we have 5 folds, so we'll have 5 scores. We should take average of them. P dummy scores test score. So we use this here because this cross-validate function will store the values as a dictionary. So we use this key test score to extract the corresponding values. Then we can store our hyperparameters and the average score in a list. So I will create a list, hyperparameter score list. And we append the parameters and the score. So you just on CRI depth and the mean scores. Okay, so here, CRI, depth, and mean scores. So that's basically how we do the cross-validation. Now, we just need to find the best hyperparameters. We can print out the numbers in a table or use a for loop to find the best average score, but we'll just print out the list in a table now, and we'll use pretty table. So, my table equals to pretty table and the color name criteria, maximum depth accuracy, and for row in hyperparameters. Let's see how our list looks like. So yeah, you have a lot of elements or rows, so we'll append one row at a time. So you just use my table, add row 0, row 1, row 2, row 3. So we first append this criteria, and then the first element is the maximum depth. And then we append the accuracy to the table. And we use round function because we don't want to see so many digital numbers, decimal numbers. So we just restrict the number to be the decimal points of 3. And then we can see our top table. Okay, here we are. So We can see there are six combinations because we have two criteria and three possible maximum depths. So two times three is six. And then we can see this combination here has the best accuracy. So we find our best combination of parameters. And we just write down here the best combination is Gini and maximum depth of 4. All right, we can use this set of hyperparameter to train and fit our decision tree. One thing to note is that we haven't trained our decision tree because we should use the whole training data. However, when doing cross-validation, we only use part of our training data. And now we want to use the whole training data. So once again, we create a tree instance decision tree, create a file. And now we know the hyperparameters we want to use, criteria equals to Gini, maximum depth equals to 4. And then we fit the model on our whole training data, X train, Y train. So that's our model, DT model. Finally, we can evaluate our model on testing set. We'll use accuracy so we can later compare with the cross-validation score. So it's actually simple. You just need to use this score function and pass the variables of testing set. And you get this 77.6% accuracy. So it's kind of lower than the cross-validation score because we have 0.812 here, but it's absolutely normal. It depends on how our data is split into training and testing. So sometimes the final score here will be higher than the cross-validation score. Sometimes you'll be lower. You just need to make sure the difference between them is not too large, not too weird. All right, that's how we tune hyperparameters using K-fold cross-validation. Thank you for watching my video and hope you enjoyed it.